It's really an honor for me to speak at the first international conference on a new paradigm in trade governance, increase domestic efficiency, and to strengthen global competitiveness, organized by Trade Analysis and Development Agency of the Ministry of Trade of Indonesia. As it is designed, this forum may serve as a scientific and strategic platform to discuss trade governance in Indonesia, involving a range of speakers and participants from various backgrounds and regions, as well as countries from Indonesia to Australia, Japan, and Singapore. This forum is also expected to strengthen networks involving the government, academic, researchers, and business players to deepen our understanding of the many aspects of trade and to better comprehend the growing importance of trade governance. I would like to begin my talks by quoting an important statement made by the President of Indonesia before the final session of the Consultative Assembly on 16 August 2017, that Indonesia is facing rapid and dynamic changes. Indonesia will also need to deal with the disruptive development of technology innovation. The statement should be considered as a wake-up call for fellow today. It means that we may need to adjust, if not overhaul, our trade agenda by, among others, adopting the value of trade governance. Ladies and gentlemen, we live in a globalized and network economy that has been shaped and reshaped by the expansion and deepening of global value chains, or GVCs. As we all aware, GVCs involve a wide range of actors and institutions and span a broad number of trade and investment disciplines. GVCs are product of trade policy reforms combined with the lowering of transport costs and the IT evolution, whose advances have given business the ability to coordinate their production needs internationally. While GVCs allow firms to concentrate on specific tasks, they also increase interdependence. The international fragmentation of production is creating new opportunities for developing countries by eliminating the need to gain competence in all aspects of a particular group. But these opportunities come with new challenges. First, trade policy, particularly preferential trade agreements, plays an important role in shaping while preferential trade agreements can create cost and regulatory incentive to source among members. Strict rules of origin tend to disincentivize the use of cheaper inputs from third countries. And second, a major concern for developing country governments like Indonesia seeking to maximize benefits from GVC participation has been to capture domestic a higher share of value added by moving up the chains. Two important policy implications can be suggested. First, integration and upgrading in GVC depends largely on domestic policy reform, and these policies go beyond narrowly defined trade policy instruments. Those countries willing to use the GVC technology as an engine for development. An open import regime in import, minimizing trade frictions and improving connectivity are critical. Second, in a globalized economy, there will be international spillovers brought about by domestic policies or by the operation of the value chains themselves. Such spillovers may include large firms abusing dominant positions, or they can result from competition between national incentive schemes designed to attract foreign direct investment. You may concur that the current normative structure of Indonesia's trade regime may be insufficiently equipped to optimally respond to the reality of fragmented production networks. A more integrated approach that considers the horizontal application of disciplines in various areas, such as transparency, standards, competition, procurement and investment in both goods and services, might offer an alternative approach to trade governance more in line with today's world of network production and trade. Now, bringing such discourses into the national context, the government of Indonesia has recently taken bold measures to reform the economy. We adopt a series of measures to improve our competitiveness. We are enhancing the efficient functioning of trade and investment at the provincial and national levels. To this end, a series of debureaucratization and deregulation packages have been introduced and implemented. There are 15 packages of deregulation introduced by the government. The packages are divided into six areas of reform. That is investment, industry, logistics, tourism, export and e-commerce. The measures in those packages include simplification of rules and procedures on trade and investment, incentives for investment in industry, financing for small and medium enterprises, provision of energy, improvement of the negative list of investment, easier procedures to build housing for low-income families, and facilitations of e-commerce.